Joshua, this is Andrew.
Andrew, how are you? What can I do for you?
Well, I've heard about what you got going on out there at this Oak Ridge thing, and I just need some help. I'm at rock bottom. My wife has kicked me out. The kids don't talk to me anymore. I'm literally staying in my car down by the railroad tracks, and I just need some help. I wonder if you can help me.
Andrew, I've been there, man. I hear the desperation and pain in your voice. Let me ask you, what are you struggling with? What's your poison?
Yes, a little bit of everything, whatever I can get my hands on.
Let me ask you this, what are you willing to do to turn this thing around and to get the help you need?
Anything. I don't have any money. I haven't used in 2 days. I guess I'm clean. Not really, but I'll do anything. I need help.
That's what I need to hear, man. I hear that. Are you aware that we're not just a rehab or a treatment center? Those are great for, you know, detoxing, but what we are is a long-term discipleship training recovery house. We are first and foremost centered on a relationship with Jesus Christ.
I don't really know all that much about God. I hope he loves me. I hope he can forgive me. I hope he can help me. I need him to help me.
He does want to help you, and he does forgive you. All it takes is this first step, like you're making with this phone call, to say, "Man, I can't do this on my own. There's something missing." And you saying that you're willing to do whatever it takes, Andrew, I want you to do a couple of things for me to make sure you understand who we are and what you're getting yourself into if you commit it. I've got one bet, Andrew, and I'm looking for the guy who is completely ready to walk away from that old life, that sin, that destructive addiction, and truly surrender his life to the God that you know at this time. Can you find a friend or anywhere where you might be able to get to a computer so that I can send you to our website?
Yeah, I can get over to the public library.
Perfect. That's a great place. All you have to do is Google Oak Ridge Disciple House. I want you to click on that website. The most important link on that website, I believe, is the handbook at the bottom of each page. Just click on that link, and Andrew, it's going to be a little bit of reading. It's 20 pages long, but it lays out for you every aspect of who we are, what we expect. And Andrew, I need you to read every word. This is the first part of saving your life, so I want you to read every word. I want you to go one other place, and I want you to go to YouTube, and I want you to YouTube Oak Ridge Disciple House. There's going to be about a 6-minute promo of who we are and a little bit about me and why I love doing what God lets me do to save men. And I want you to watch that video, and I want you to pray as you're watching. I just want you to say a small prayer. I want you to say, "God, is this where you're leading me?" And I want you to listen really closely to your heart, okay? I want you to go through those two things. I want you to take your time, I want you to pray, and I want you to call me.
All right, Joshua, I'll get to the computer, and I will do those two things, and I will call you back.
Hey, buddy, let me pray with you real quick. Father, I just pray for Andrew right now. I pray that you would speak to his heart. He said he doesn't know you, but he knows of you, and that's okay. That's where it all starts. I pray you would let Andrew know if we are a good fit for him, and then I want you to let us know, Father, if Andrew's a good fit for us. In Jesus' name, amen.
What if you could go back and relive one day of your life all over again and unmake the mistake that left you a million miles away from the you you once knew? Now yesterday's shame keeps saying that you'll never get back on track. But what if I told you you're one step away from surrender, one step away from coming home, coming home. One step from arms wide open, his love has never let you go. Doesn't matter how far you've gone.
first, of course, I didn't have a problem. There was nothing wrong with me. I don't know what you're talking about. Alcohol?
Nobody trusts me.
Well, I'd probably be homeless, living under a bridge or something, or in jail.
Even if I was awake for 3 weeks.
Crack cocaine.
God chose me, you know, and didn't let me die in the hell that I was living in. With addiction to methamphetamines, they were probably killing me.
Living on the streets, serving a prison sentence, shooting heroin.
I don't feel like I deserve to be loved anymore.
We're selfish individuals.
Destroying myself slowly but surely.
Honestly, I don't know where I'd be.
Hi, my name is Joshua Harris, and I'm the founder and director of the Oak Ridge Disciple House. We want to thank you for your interest today.
Good afternoon. Thank you for calling Oak Ridge.
Hey, Joshua, it's Andrew. I went to the library, got there, read the handbook. I read every word. It took me a while, but I took my time and read it. And I watched the YouTube video, and I'm calling you back. Do you still have that bed for me?
Andrew, I'm a man of my word, and I told you I would hold this bed until I heard back from you, and I'm so glad to hear your voice again and that you're safe. Oh, Andrew, I've got one question for you. Do I ask this of every man? Because it was asked of me almost 13 years ago. Three words. Are you ready for help?
Yes, I am.
Okay. What we do next, Andrew, is we want to meet you, and we want to look in your eyes, and I want you to meet all the guys that are currently going through discipleship recovery right now in the house. Meet our staff. I've got four staff guys in there, all graduates of Oak Ridge, which they know exactly what you're about to go through because they went through it themselves, and they graduated and stayed on to help men like you find freedom that they found. So we want to meet you. We want to share a little bit of our story with you, 3 minutes each or so, and we call it a roundtable interview. Can you find a ride up here?
I will find someone, Joshua, and I will get up there. You tell me when, and I'll be there.
Andrew, I want you to, for one thing, we love you. We don't even know you, but we love you because God has introduced us to you. And I hear your desperation, and I hear your passion to get help and to hopefully restore your family. And I'm telling you, you can do all those things. And you're at that place like we like that says, you never know God's all you need.
Until
God's all you have left, and I look forward to meeting Andrew. And let's see what God's doing here.
Hear the voice of love that's calling. There's a chair that waits for you, and a friend who understands everything you're going through. But you keep standing at a distance, in the shadows of your shame. But there's a light of hope that's shining. Won't you come and take your place and bring it all to the table? It's nothing he ain't seen before. For all your sin, all your sorrow and your sadness, there's a Savior and he calls. Bring it all to the table. He can see the weight you carry and the fears that hold your heart. But through the cross you've been forgiven. You're accepted as you are. And bring it all to the table.
The answer lies in a personal relationship to Jesus Christ. This time can come forth by nothing but concentration and redoubled concentration on Him. can we ever remain powerless? Dreams lost, they have found you, and the heart that once was beating is coming back to life, coming back to life. But something inside you can't deny. And take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the Word of God, praying always with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit, and watching thereunto with all perseverance and supplication for all men.
Put us in a time of, you know, reflection or step 10 for continuing to take personal inventory. If I'm wondering, you know, what in the world is going on? If I'm catching discipline, well, I need to find out what that is.
See some of the people that own these houses and they have these yards, and I realize there's no way that they could do it on their own, and so it's kind of a blessing to give.
Awesome. It's a way to give back. I've been a taker my whole life, and so to give back means a lot to me.
Good man is learning how to put people before yourself, so I enjoy it.
There's a better life. SOS, surrender, obedience, service.
We are made right with God by placing our faith in Jesus Christ, and this is true for everyone who believes, no matter who we are.
He testified into the wild canyons of youth. Oh, there's a world.
We call ourselves People Sharing Jesus. There are so many things that happen around here that you should be involved in. Great music, opportunities for spiritual growth for all ages, opportunities to participate in missions around the world. I don't want you to miss out.
Two simple, strong points.
the first one. None of us is any better than anyone else. His second clear point is, unless you repent, whatever bad thing happened to that person that you might think is worse than you, something far worse awaits.
Accept the things I cannot change, the courage to change the things I can, and the wisdom to know the difference. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Sunshine. It's 5 o'clock, man. You're late for chapel.
One day off.
Hey, there's never a day off in God's army, brother.
We are those who have died to sin. How can we live in it any longer? For we know that our old self was crucified with him, so that the body ruled by sin might be done away with, that we should no longer be slaves to sin. Because anyone who has died has been set free from sin. Death no longer has mastery over him. Count yourselves dead to sin, but alive to God in Christ Jesus. Offer yourselves to God as those who have been brought from death to life. For sin shall no longer be your master, because you are not under the law, but under grace.